Hello, my name is Vivian Rowan and I am a cruise ship speaker. I got involved in cruise ship speaking mainly through a young Egyptian gentleman who worked in the restaurant on a cruise. And he saw my necklaces and I explained what it was about, but he knew nothing of his history. So every night I would sit with him and I would tell him the history of ancient Egypt, the pharaohs, Tutankhamun. And gradually passengers listened and they started to ask me questions. Eventually, the cruise director approached me and said, "Have you ever thought of giving lectures on a cruise ship?" And I said, "No." And he put me in touch with an agency in Yorkshire. And they put me onto my very first cruise ship, which was Thompson Celebration. As my career as a cruise ship speaker developed, I have gone into more ancient civilizations, the Aztecs, Rome, the Byzantine Empire, Greece, Pompeii, Athens, so it's a broader knowledge, even down to the Amazon jungle, all these sorts of things, which I now have an interest in. When the cruise ship company ask for what they want, they send me a list of either destination, general interest, or enrichment, so I can cover. If they want an enrichment, I'll do X marks the spot, which is all the lost treasures of the world, and it covers everywhere the ships go. The ancient seven wonders of the world, which is places they can go to, there's only one left. The new seven wonders of the world, which again, people go to. From starting off with obviously the history of ancient Egypt, which is my passion, I do other subjects. I cover Rome, the Byzantine Empire. We do Pompeii, we do Athens, we do the Greeks, and all these places that we go to on the cruises, on the itinerary. So I look at the itinerary, see where the ships are going, and I relate my talks to the itineraries to suit whichever, you know, the ship is asking for. From the feedback I've had from passengers, the enrichment talks that I do does enhance them. They'll come to me and they say, "Oh, I remember that now, I saw that." You've actually brought back memories. And some people say, "Well, I've been there, but I didn't know that." And you've explained what it's about and the story of it. And they go off quite happy then, because they do know, they've been to see something and now they know what it's about because I've told them. And they go off quite happily. I am sure that what I do when I give enrichment talks, I give destination talks, is essential. People want to know. They want to know the places they're going to. They want to know the history of the places they're going to. And then they have a better understanding when they do go. They know exactly what they're looking at. There's nothing worse than going to a place and thinking, "Oh, what's it all about?" Whereas I can do that side of it before they go. So let's say an example, the Colosseum. They go and see this magnificent building, which is one of the new wonders of the world. But they don't know the story of it. They don't know who built it, what went on in there, and I can do that for them.